Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. On this episode, let's take a closer look at using albums in Photos on your Mac. So from questions I get and comments I see, I gather there's some general misconception of what albums in Photos are. So here I am in the latest version of Photos in El Capitan, and I've got a small photo collection here. And there's two ways I can view it. One is by choosing Photos on the left sidebar. The other is under Albums, choosing All Photos. If you don't see the left sidebar, go to View and you can hide or show sidebar here. Now, if I choose Photos here, then I get everything sorted by time. So I've got everything broken into years and I can go down into an individual photo or move through years, collections, and moments. Every photo is represented under Photos exactly once, and they're all in time order, from the first photo you've got in your collection to the most recent one. Under Albums, you've got All Photos, and this is a special photo album that includes every photo you've ever taken, also starting with the oldest one to the latest one. Now, this is just kind of a flat list here. So you're just going to see every photo represented, not broken up into years or places or anything like that like you would under Photos. And you can create your own albums as well. So you've got this general album here and you can create your own. You can see I've created some there. Let's go ahead and create a new album, File, New Album, or Command N. And I'll just call it Test 1. And I can now select the photos I want to be in there, or I can just hit continue and leave it as an empty album. So I've got this empty album here called Test 1. Now I can view my photos any way I want. I can go here in the Photos view or under All Photos, whatever I want to do, and I can drag a photo to an album. And I can just continue to do that. Now when I view this album, those photos are in there. And they're still going to be listed under All Photos, and I'll still find them here under the Photos view, but they'll also be listed here in this album, Test 1. Now here's where the misconception comes into play. People either think sometimes that because they've put a photo in here, it is now in this Test 1 album and it is nowhere else. Or the other misconception is that they think there's a copy here, because if you go to All Photos, you can see there's one of those photos. And it's also here. So now I've got two copies of the photo. And it gets even worse is if I go and I create another new album, call that Test 2, and let's say I select that same photo and I put it in there. Now if I look under Test 1, I've got that photo, and Test 2, I've got the same photo, and it's also under All Photos as well. So you may think that you now have three or more copies of this photo in your collection. In fact, there's only one copy of this photo in the library. You see, unlike physical albums where you would have a book and you would put the photo in the album, and if you had the same photo in more than one album, you would have a copy in each album. These aren't physical albums though. So these are more like playlists in iTunes if you've used those. There's actually one photo in your library, but you're looking at lists that show you different photos that are stored in your library. So you can have the same photo in as many albums as you want, but there's only one actual photo. For instance, let's go here into All Photos, go to this photo of my dog Jack when he was a puppy, and let's edit it. And I'm going to do some adjustments, and I'm going to change it to black and white. Now I'm going to go back up to the All Photos level here, and you can see all the other photos, and I've got this one of Jack that's now in black and white. Now if I go to Test Album 1, you can see the photo there shows now as black and white because I've changed it. If I go to Test 2, sure enough, now also I see that that photo is black and white because there's only one photo. It's in one place in the library, but I have these lists that show me photos of different things. So keep in mind that Photos is a very versatile tool. Some people may never use albums at all and only view their photos in chronological order with the Photos view. Other people may not like this view and just prefer to have one long big list of all their photos and look at the All Photos album. other people may want to put all their photos into albums. And you can do that. You can restrict yourself to having every single photo in one album only and then put them together like that. And that kind of emulates how events worked in iPhoto. You could certainly do that. It's up to you. But you could also use albums to put pictures in multiple places so that you can find them. For instance, say you like to take pictures on vacation and you like to create an album when you're done with the vacation with all the photos from that vacation. But you also like to take pictures of clouds. And every time you take a picture of a cloud, you want to put it into an album called Clouds. Well, suppose you're on vacation and you take a picture of a cloud. Well, with albums, you could put that same photo into the vacation album and you could put it into the clouds album so that you've got it in both places, but there's only one copy in your library. You just can view your library in different ways. One way would be through that clouds album. Another way would be through that vacation album that you created. And you can always go into these albums and you can adjust things. You can select one and remove it. I just hit the delete key there. You can continue to add more photos by dragging and dropping into it. And there's all sorts of things you could do. You can even rearrange the order of photos in albums like I did by dragging and dropping. So you can, for instance, create an album that has all the photos from your current vacation, but you can also create an album that just has your favorites. So if you want to show them to somebody, and if you're short on time and you just want to show them the 20 best, you can show them that one album. And if they want to see all of your vacation photos, they could see the entire album that includes all the photos from that vacation.